Hey, it's Julius from Pix4D Agriculture. I'm excited to demonstrate an efficient Pix4D Fields workflow for mapping weeds on fallow. We will be focusing on green on brown spot spraying using RGB drone imagery. With this technique, you can save 60% and more on inputs. Starting with map generation, progressing through boundary setup and layer trimming, we will create an RGB vegetation index, effectively separating the soil from the weeds to precise thresholding. Next, we will craft an application-ready spot spraying map from our data and ensure it's exported in a format compatible with sprayers. For more insights on drone mapping or green on brown weed detection, check out the additional videos linked in the description below. Now, let's get started. This use case, we are working with an RGB dataset with a 20 megapixel sensor, captured at a 50 meter flight height. This provides us with a detailed ground resolution of 1 cm per pixel. I will load the imagery folder into a new Pix4D Fields project, opting for fast processing to rapidly generate our map. The next step involves using the boundary tools to digitize the boundary of our field. This is a crucial step for both trimming and creating the application map. Once we have our boundary set, we will trim the orthomosaic to just the field's area. Inspecting our map, the weed nests are distinctly visible. To enhance this, let's create an RGB vegetation index using the index tool. For this scenario, TGI is our index of choice. The next crucial step is to use the histogram handles to threshold our dataset. This process will effectively remove non-vegetation pixels. Make sure to use the split comparison tool to fine-tune your threshold, ensuring it's sensitive enough for accurate weed detection. Now, let's move on to creating a prescription map. We will use the operation tool with the zonation scenario to apply based on our thresholded index layer. It is important to adjust the grid rotation and cell size to align with your tramlines and the width of your sprayer sections. In the zonation settings, I am going to select a single zone for a straightforward on and off map and setting the zone detail to fine. At this point, you will notice that all cells containing at least one visible pixel are active. If you prefer less sensitivity, the exclude cells with less than X% visible pixels setting is adjustable. In my case, I will set it so cells with just a single pixel are deactivated. Using the split comparison mode, we can verify the accuracy of our prescription map. Although results with a multispectral sensor using the NDVI index are usually more precise, the difference isn't substantial in most cases. Finally, it's time to assign a prescription rate. In our example, this technique allows us to save up to 69% on chemicals. We are now ready to export our green and brown spot spraying map in various formats. Shapefile or ISO XML are the preferred formats for field sprayers and tractors. This technique leverages high-resolution RGB sensors for efficient green-on-brown weed mapping, allowing you to save 60% and more on inputs. And that's it for today. See you in the next video.